everyone. I'm Dr. Dipali Rao. I'm consultant clinical psychologist in the Vimhans Youth Services Department of Vimhans Hospital. I welcome you all to the next session in the Vimhans series of talks on adolescent mental health. In the past sessions, we've touched upon subjects such as mood disorders, specifically depression and bipolar disorder in teens, and other generic mental health issues that have been covered in an overview panel discussion. These have been covered by eminent presenters and panelists from Vimhans and outside. In the session today, we will take up issues of self-harm and their management in teens. We have two eminent presenters from Vimhans to highlight important aspects of the subject, Dr. Urvashi Anand and Dr. Malika Patri.
So what do I mean by emotional vulnerability? So it's almost like you have genetic vulnerability, you have emotional vulnerability. So since childhood, temperamentally, you're a highly sensitive individual. You also tend to react to small things in a very big way. So problem itni thi, but aapka reaction jo tha, wo itna zyada tha. Okay? And ek bar reaction ho gaya, it's difficult to get back to the baseline, to cool down. So say for example, somebody who does not have that emotional vulnerability, they will become okay emotionally within maybe 2-3 hours. But a person who is emotionally vulnerable, he will take 2-3 days also, maybe, to just to get back to the baseline, to feel relaxed, to feel calm. Okay? And invalidating environment means, see, it's not necessary that a family should, you know, environment should have abuse or neglect in it for it to be called an invalidating environment. Invalidating environment means that you're not validating a person's feelings or experiences. Okay, you're saying ye galat hai, tumhara perception galat hai, tumko samajh mein nahi aata. So what happens in an invalidating environment is that the child's expression of his private experiences are not validated. They're dismissed. Experiences of painful emotions, jab wo kuch negative feeling ya koi negative event ke bare mein bata rahe hain, they're expressing themselves, that expression is stopped or it is disregarded. Okay, it's as being not so important. It's trivialized. It's ridiculed. So mazak uda dete hain bacche ka, or they're punished for expressing something like this, or it's completely ignored. Okay, so when things like these happen, that the child learns two things. One is that he learns to believe that his actions, his thoughts, his feelings, they just simply don't matter in this family. Okay. And because of that, they find it difficult to understand what is happening to them, recognize and label their emotions. And even if they're feeling the emotion or they're perceiving a certain thing, they're always in doubt, you know, whether what I'm perceiving is right or not. Okay, or whatever emotion I'm feeling, is it right or appropriate for this situation or not. Okay, so they keep looking for external cues to try to understand what to do, how to feel. Okay, and during childhood, many children then try to up the volume. That means aur zor se bolna, aur zyada koshish karna batane ki, you know, to convince the invalidating environment, that is, you know, the invalidating invalidating parents, that what they're feeling is real. Okay, but no change happens there. Okay, so a combination of emotional vulnerability and an invalidating environment together lead to the child not developing healthy emotional expressions, expressive behaviors, and then the child somehow discovers self-harm as one of the coping mechanisms. Okay, so there are a lot of risk factors for self-harm behavior. So besides the invalidating environment, there may be abuse, physical, sexual, emotional abuse, poor bonding with the parents, so poor attachment. There may be a family history of depression and anxiety, poor communication in the family, inadequate parenting, In addition to an invalidating environment, they also might find it difficult to balance between being a nurturing parent and being an authoritative parent in setting rules and limits. And they experience a sense of powerlessness at an early age because nobody is hearing them, nobody is validating their emotions. And they have poor interpersonal skills. So whatever friendships they have, they'll be very superficial. There'll be very superficial communication with relatives, but there are no intimate connections. Okay, and low self-esteem, social isolation, alienation from peer group, identity issues, all of these also are risk factors. So what are the signs that somebody might be self-harming? Okay. So unexplained or clustered, that means lots of scars or marks which may be dried or old, or maybe fresh cut bruises or burns on the body.